How y'all doing tonight? Y'all alright?
Yeah!
I was simply doing something a little different right now. Yo, you guys don't have two mics, so we're gonna try to do this a little differently, I guess. We're gonna. Me and you? Alright, okay. The piece I'm about to perform right now is from my new upcoming EP called Humble Hollywood. And it's a hip hop, you know, slash poetry, emotion type album. And I really wanted to give it to you all right now with no music, nothing, just me, my partner right here, and we're gonna see how y'all like it, okay?
All right.
The piece is called The Going Gets Tough. I gotta get up, cause it ain't getting any easier. And even when I chill, I still need a breather. Life is such a cheater, and I don't know how to be her. I swear, everywhere I go, she already be there.
Bitch already there.
Left in the dust. I feel smoke like some reefer.
Oh, that next blunt, nigga.
Reminded every time that I ain't shit if I leave her.
I ain't shit if I leave her.
I just want to get ahead, but she don't want to go down. But yeah, I'm force fed. Well, who cooked you in my mouth? She makes me eat my words if I ever get out of line. So I can tell them what I learned if I ever get out of line. Swallowing my pride will probably make her proud. But persistent with resistance will always make her smile.
You got it, baby.
They say if you want to see her laugh, go ahead and tell God your plan.
I'm going to do it like this.
And if you want to make her mad, you tell him you're the man. And I just want to be a man. So this is where I'll start. Cause the going gets tough. Even when it gets hard.
Yo, check it. I want to live.
I want to live.
I want to love.
I want to love.
I want to shake hands. Sometimes I want to hug.
I want to hug.
I want a lady friend. Should I even need a bruh? Cause the tough get going. So the going get tough.
We get tough.
Check it, I want to live.
I want to live.
I want to love.
I want to love.
I want to shake hands. Sometimes I want to hug.
I do want to hug.
I want a lady friend.
Yeah.
I even need a bruh. Because the tough get going. So the going get tough, yo. Check it. It's the big stage. Bright lights, boy. Better hit the shot. Niggas is steady waiting. Patient. Lying on your spot. Shit, need to give it all you got.
Everything.
Before you end up out the game. It'd be a shame you suffer the face so lame. After all the goddamn labor pains. Time in the studio. Blocked. On the corner. Working with the Tulio. Blocks. Mama hollering. The drama just don't stop.
Never.
Your daughter need a new coat. But guess what? You broke, nigga. No stock.
Mm-mm.
No cash. No assets. Niggas can't cop. That thing on the new rims. The roofless. Drops.
Hold on.
Whether hustling or punching 9 to 5 clocks, the recession's in. We gotta hustle to the guap. I don't know about you, but I'm trying to get a lot.
Yeah.
Put a house up on that bitch and keep the gate locked. My AK on cop, staring out the window, praying I don't never have to let go of one of my kinfolk.
I wanna live.
I wanna live.
I wanna love.
I wanna love.
I wanna shake hands.
I wanna shake hands.
And sometimes I wanna hug.
I need a hug too.
I want a lady friend.
I even need a bruh.
Cause the tough gets going.
So the going get tough.
I said I wanna live.
I wanna live.
I wanna love.
I wanna love.
I wanna hold hands.
I wanna shake hands.
And sometimes I wanna hug.
I wanna hug, baby.
I want a lady friend.
I even need a bruh.
The tough gets going,
so what we do?
We get tough.
Word.
Thank y'all.
So when you guys see those flyers coming across to you on Facebook and hand to hand, this cat is, he's imperative to the design status of Urban Nuisance. So he's got a funny story to tell. He says it's not urban, it's not funky, it ain't fly, but it's funny. So y'all put your hands together for Phil. Energy, Phil.
All right, thanks. I'm Phil, and the answer to your question is no, I'm not part of the Geek Squad.
Not by important
anyway. Not by important. So I'm going to tell you guys a little story. Those that know me as a storyteller in the sense that I make comic strips, and most of the writing I do is usually scripts for drawings. And a comic I do right now is called Retail Sunshine, and it's about working in a retail electronics store. That doesn't necessarily have anything to do with the Geek Squad, but if you think it does, that's okay. And so I'm writing a book right now, and it's a kind of a storybook, but it's with the Retail Sunshine characters. And the only thing you need to know is that blue shirts are employees, yellow shirts are the guys at the front who have to make sure you're not stealing anything, blank shirts are customers, and clipboards are managers, because they're always carrying a clipboard with them wherever they go, because they're managing people. So here we go. And this poem is about a very special day that is coming up very soon, known as Black Friday. It's called "'Twas the Day After Turkey." "'Twas the day after turkey, when all through the store, not a blue shirt had slept much the evening before. The great deals they adorned all departments with care, in hopes that the customers soon would be there. The blank shirts were freezing, all waiting outside, some grumbling and mumbling, how long is this line? Though the employees knew they'd get through this somehow, they all shared the same thought, we are in for it now. When to the surprise of all employees, the yellow shirt, LP, was knocked to his knees. It seemed a few blank shirts forced open the doors, and also they'd be the first ones in the store. There was running and shoving and rudeness to boot. No one cared how they acted, they just wanted the loot. When what to my quivering jaw made it drop, but a clipboard who threw out his hands and yelled, "Stop!" Like the fleeing of cockroaches frightened by light, all the blue shirts stepped back to make way for his might. With the vein on his forehead swelling big as a cow, the crowd clearly was scared from the sweat on their brow. Now I know that you're cold, your extremities numb, but as God is my witness, you will not act so dumb. I don't care if you're here for a TV or a scanner, you will all wait in line in a civilized manner. And with that, it began, all those hours of shopping, all the customers thrilled that the prices were dropping, filling baskets at speeds that would surely turn heads, while the blue shirts were secretly wishing them dead. Cheap computers and cameras, handheld games, DVDs, no one questioned the fact they were made overseas. Even items their budgets would barely allow, they would pay for it all, though they didn't know how. As the moments turned minutes and the minutes to hours, every shirt's attitude was beginning to sour. They were clearly outnumbered, it wouldn't last long, and would likely go mad with one more Christmas song. It was then that the sandwiches quickly appeared, a clear sign the halfway point was finally here. And though most of the food really was a mistake, no one cared since they finally now had a break. A quick lunch that was sadly not 1 minute more, sure to cause indigestion, then back onto the floor, back to blank shirts whose patients were steadily leaving, and whose biggest mistake was the act of conceiving. With the bargains and doorbusters now running out, all the blank shirts still shopping were starting to pout. Perhaps next week they'd acquire the sale of their dreams. Early birds do not always eat first, so it seems. All the customers gone, closing time drawing near, every shirt in the store had a mission to fear. Cigarettes and gum wrappers just lying about, empty bottles, used tissues, they would all be thrown out. With the store now devoid of the holiday madness, a lone blue shirt complained of exhaustion and sadness. And I heard her exclaim as her voice filled with sorrow, "Man, this royally bites because I open tomorrow."